In this video, we are going to discuss journey to the end of the earth line for line. Early this year, I found myself aboard a Russian research vessel, the Akademik Sokolsky, heading towards the coldest, driest, windiest continent in the world, Antarctica. My journey began 13.09 degrees north of the equator in Madras and involved crossing 9 time zones, 6 checkpoints, 3 bodies of water, and at least as many ecospheres. Let's understand the meaning of certain words from this paragraph. First of them is aboard, which means on board. You are aboard a ship if you are traveling on a ship. Then vessel means ship. Russian research ship. The name was Akademik Sokolsky. The meaning of ecospheres, many of you might know already. Parts of the universe habitable by living organism. Any place where living organisms can live is called a ecosphere. The gist of this paragraph is that the narrator or the author, Tishani Doshi, found herself on board a Russian ship named the Akademik Sokolsky. It was a research ship. It was not a normal passenger ship. This ship was heading towards Antarctica, which has been called the coldest, driest, and the windiest continent in the world. Her journey began from Chennai. Madras is the old name of Chennai. And Chennai is situated at 13.09 degrees north of the equator. You must have studied in geography, longitude and latitude. Madras is situated at 13.09 degrees north of the equator. Equator is the imaginary line that divides the earth into two parts. And she crossed 9 time zones. We know that in India we have only one time zone, but in many countries they have different time zones and different countries have different time zones. So she crossed 9 time zones, 6 checkpoints. Checkpoint is any point where strangers or you can say the persons who come there are checked. She also crossed 3 water bodies. They may be ocean, sea, lake, strait or any other water body. And she also crossed 3 ecospheres. You can see the picture of Antarctica. You can see here Chennai, 13.09 degrees north of equator. This red line is the equator. The picture of the ship for you, Akademik Sokolsky. It was a Russian research vessel or ship. The author traveled for about 100 hours and she used 3 modes of transport: car, airplane, and a ship. Next paragraph. By the time I actually set foot on the Antarctic continent, I had been traveling over 100 hours in combination of a car, an aeroplane, and a ship. So my first emotion on facing Antarctica's expansive white landscape and uninterrupted blue horizon was relief, followed up with an immediate and profound wonder. Wonder at its immensity, its isolation, but mainly at how there could have been a time when India and Antarctica were part of the same landmass. Certain difficult words have been highlighted here. Expensive. It is different from expensive, which means costly. This word expansive, expensive, means covering wide area in terms of space, or in one word you can say extensive, dur dur tak phela hua. Next word is profound, which means very great or intense. Profound feelings, profound wonder. Isolation means separation. Landmass means a continent or other large body of land. The gist of this paragraph is that the author traveled for about 100 hours in a car, an airplane and a ship. Her first emotion when she reached Antarctica was relief. Why relief? Because she had been traveling for 100 hours in continuation. Naturally, she was very tired. So when she reached Antarctica, she felt highly relieved. She felt a huge relief. She calls the landscape of Antarctica expansive, very widespread and white, because it is covered with snow, and uninterrupted blue horizon. Uninterrupted, you can say, means without any interruption, when there are no clouds to interrupt you. Blue horizon. Horizon means the place where earth and sky seem to meet. So to see the white landscape and blue horizon, her first emotion was relief. Her second emotion was wonder, surprise, amazement. What was she amazed at? She was amazed by the immensity, tremendousity, hugeness of this continent and its isolation. It is totally isolated from the other parts of the world. But the main reason for her amazement was she could not believe that once India was a part of Gondwana land, the supercontinent of which Antarctica was also a part. India and Antarctica were part of the same landmass, and this landmass was, yes, Gondwana land, a supercontinent. You can see in the picture, blue horizon and white extensive landscape of Antarctica. Next paragraph. 650 million years ago, a giant amalgamated southern supercontinent, Gondwana, did indeed exist, centered roughly around the present day Antarctica. Things were quite different then. Humans hadn't arrived on the global scene, and the climate was much warmer, hosting a huge variety of flora and fauna. For 500 million years, Gondwana thrived, but around the time when the dinosaurs were wiped out and the age of the mammals got underway, the landmass was forced to separate into countries, shaping the globe much as we know it today. You can see the meanings of some difficult words. One of them is amalgamated, which means combined or united to form one structure. Thrive means to prosper or flourish. In Hindi we call it phalna phulna. The gist of this paragraph is that 650 million years ago, there was a combined southern supercontinent named Gondwana or Gondwana land. The center of this supercontinent was Antarctica. The things were very different at that time. Human beings were not there, and the earth was very beautiful and intact from the human influence. The climate was very warm at that time, and there was a huge variety of फ्लोरा एंड फौना. फ्लोरा मीन्स वेजिटेशन, प्लांट्स एंड ट्रीज, एंड फौना मीन्स एनिमल्स, वाइल्ड एनिमल्स. दिस कंटिन्यूड फॉर अबाउट 500 मिलियन ईयर्स. दिस गोंडवाना लैंड प्रॉस्पर्ड, फ्लरिश्ड. बट वेन द डायनासोर्स वर वाइप्ड आउट, वेन दे वर एक्सटिंक्ट एंड द एज ऑफ द मैमल्स अराइव्ड, दिस लैंड मास वॉज सेपरेटेड इंटू मैनी कंट्रीज एंड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ इट वी हैव द प्रेजेंट ग्लोब, 7 कॉन्टिनेंट्स. वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट बेटर थ्रू दीज पिक्चर्स. यू कैन सी गोंडवाना लैंड, अरेबिया, अफ्रीका, साउथ अमेरिका, इंडिया, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, अंटार्कटिका वर पार्ट ऑफ द सेम सुपर कॉन्टिनेंट. देन डायनासोर्स वर एक्सटिंक्ट, द मैमल्स अराइव्ड ऑन द अर्थ एंड गोंडवाना लैंड एक्चुअली सेपरेटेड इंटू मैनी कंट्रीज एंड कॉन्टिनेंट्स. यू कैन सी हियर साउथ अमेरिका ड्रिफ्टेड टूवर्ड्स वेस्ट एंड जॉइंट नॉर्थ अमेरिका. अफ्रीका ड्रिफ्टेड टूवर्ड्स नॉर्थ. इंडिया ऑल्सो ड्रिफ्टेड टूवर्ड्स नॉर्थ एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया ड्रिफ्टेड टूवर्ड्स साउथ. अंटार्कटिका वॉज लेफ्ट वेयर इट वॉज. द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ, टू विजिट अंटार्कटिका नाउ इज टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट हिस्ट्री, टू गेट अ ग्रेस्प ऑफ वेयर वी हैव कम फ्रॉम एंड वेयर वी कुड पॉसिबली बी हेडिंग. इट्स टू अंडरस्टैंड द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ कॉर्डिलेरन फोल्ड्स एंड प्री कैम्ब्रियन ग्रेनाइट शील्ड्स, ओजोन एंड कार्बन, एवोल्यूशन एंड एक्सटिंक्शन. वैन यू थिंक अबाउट ऑल दैट कैन हैपन इन अ मिलियन ईयर्स, इट कैन गेट प्रीटी माइंड बॉगलिंग. इमेजिन इंडिया पुशिंग नॉर्थवर्ड्स, जैमिंग अगेंस्ट एशिया टू बकल इट्स क्रस्ट एंड फॉर्म द हिमालयास. साउथ अमेरिका ड्रिफ्टिंग ऑफ टू जॉइन नॉर्थ अमेरिका, ओपनिंग अप द ड्रेक पैसेज टू क्रिएट अ कोल्ड सर्कमपोलर करेंट, कीपिंग अंटार्कटिका फ्रिजिड, डेसोलेट एंड एट द बॉटम ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. सर्टेन डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स हियर फॉर यू डियर स्टूडेंट्स. माइंड बॉगलिंग मीन्स ओवरवेलमिंग और स्टार्टलिंग, समथिंग दैट बॉगल्स योर माइंड, समथिंग दैट पजल्स योर माइंड. Frigid means very cold in temperature. Desolate means uninhabited and giving an impression of bleak emptiness, wilderness. Certain terms had been used in that paragraph. You can understand them better through these pictures. Cordilleran folds are formed by system or group of parallel mountain ranges together with the intervening plateaus and other features. Precambrian granite shields. These are the granite sheets which were formed approximately 4.5 billion years ago. Then you can understand the formation of Himalayas. India pushed northward and jammed against Asia and created the mighty Himalayas. South America drifted towards North America and opened up the Drake Passage. Drake Passage, dear students, is the body of water between the southern tip of South America at Cape Town, Cape Horn, Chile, and the South Shetland Islands of Antarctica. This drifting also created cold circumpolar current, ACC. It's an ocean current that flows clockwise from west to east around Antarctica. Next part of the chapter will be discussed in the next video.